Well, it was almost a year ago we were dealing with a workplace shooting at a granite company in Edgewood in Harford County. And today, another mass shooting, another company,
this time
a warehouse up in Harford County in Aberdeen. I don't even know what to make of this, C4. Where do we go from here?
Just yesterday in Wisconsin, we had a workplace shooting where four people were shot and the gunman was killed. Four people, one of them critical. We are seeing too much of this workplace shooting. We also had the Capital Gazette newspaper where tragically someone came and killed individuals. It really makes you wonder, Stacey, whether or not our reality, I mean, we've had mass shootings now at concerts, we've had them at theaters, we've had them, of course, in schools, whether or not we need to have a secure situation of maybe metal detectors at every workplace. I mean, I don't like to say that, but think about where we are in 2018.
Yeah, sadly. And this is a massive complex with several buildings, three
Absolutely.
Separate big warehouse buildings. And we understand from a lot of people from earlier today that one of the buildings had metal detectors
yep.
as you entered
the main
building.
That's the main
the
one.
Other buildings did not. We did understand not. That some people had to lock their phones up when they got to work during the day. So, I mean, why did the one building have metal detectors and the others did not?
You know, we're in a reality now where why do some schools have metal detectors and others don't? Why do some schools have resource officers and others don't? I really think we need, I hate to say this, to be uniformed almost in our approach to safety now, where we have every essential element of safety. If you now go to a courthouse, there's metal detectors everywhere. It's law enforcement everywhere. If we go to Annapolis, where I used to work, there's metal detectors, law enforcement everywhere. I don't like thinking about that in other locations. But, Stacey, these are soft targets. And we've heard from terrorism experts, whether it's domestic terrorism or foreign terrorism, people look for soft targets. Where is there not going to be anybody to confront me? And apparently today it was at the Rite Aid Liberty Center, that location, where they determined a woman, by the way, a woman showed up with a gun, who's, by the way, wounded and currently in a hospital someplace. We don't know specifically where. It really is, you don't know what to say in situations like this.
Yeah, and you said the soft targets. We understand that this warehouse is kind of off the beaten path, kind of
in
a wooded area.
It's out in the woods in a situation where one of the neighbors said you wouldn't even know something this massive was here unless you physically came back. You can't see it from the highway. There's no, you know, it's multiple football fields almost. People can understand how big this place is with multiple bays, where the open bays where trucks can, 18-wheel trucks can back up and be unloaded. It's one of the main distribution centers for Rite Aid where they send all their stuff out to all their stores across the country.
I know some people always use the term that they're getting numb to this because I think there's been a mass shooting of sorts almost every day.
Stacey, I've been on the air now for 11 years. My first situation in 2007 was the Virginia Tech shooting. I've been on the air, tragically, for the Amish school shooting where those little girls were killed in Pennsylvania, to Newtown where those children were killed on air. We were getting numbers, started at one, then went to three, then went to five. I mean, I don't want to say numbing, but it's no longer a shock to me when all of a sudden news breaks in and there's been a mass shooting while I'm on the air. It's too often.
And that's a very sad statement.
It's horrible.
It's a really sad statement. C4 on Daily 9
Thank you, Stacey.
Right here on WBAL News Radio 1090.